there, guys. Coaster Chal here, Doncaster born, but built for theme parks, and welcome to a theme park newsroom update. Now, this is not the first video, or not the last video, we're expecting today. Obviously, I'm going to be uploading the trip preview, so by now you'll see that that's getting ready, set to be premiered tonight. We do also have an update that we're expecting in the next few hours, probably from Six Flags Fiesta Texas, as a bit of an update on what's going on with there. I'll also have a look at the little corner of what's been revealed in terms of the logo as well, so I'll look at both of them in that video. That should be online tonight as well. But this one focuses on Frontier City, and this is on the removal on the park's website and the rides list of Geronimo Skycoaster at the park. So I'm going to look at the site in question, look at the details, and share my thoughts on what this could mean for Frontier City going ahead for the next season. So, before we get started with all of that, guys, make sure you do like the video if you loved it. Comment down below your thoughts and opinions on this. Subscribe if you're new around here. Click the notification bell so you never miss another YouTube video. Also, guys, check the description down below for social media links and the Google Forms link where you can submit your own ideas for the channel. Don't forget, if you do see me at Alton Towers tomorrow, don't be afraid to say hi. And for now, guys, let's have a look at exactly what's going on with Geronimo Skycoaster at Frontier City Theme Park in Oklahoma. So, as told by sources, Geronimo Skycoaster has been removed from the park's website and the rides list, and as I've seen myself, that seems to be the case. Now, this first opened way back in 1995, manufactured by Skycoaster Incorporated. Now, obviously, you'll be wanting to know how the site looks for this attraction. Well, as you can see already on your screen, it is a pretty decent site. Now, I'm going to go into more detail about why I predict what I predict, but as you can see, if you include the abandoned Nightmare Mine building. Of course, Nightmare Mine was the indoor roller coaster at the park that closed way back in 2000. If you include that building as well, you can see it's a pretty decent amount of land, big enough for a brand new coaster. Now, obviously, there's a few things that could go down here in terms of different routes of investment. I'm going to go into more detail about them in a little bit, but in terms of basics and my predictions, what this could mean is one of two things. Either maybe this is a flat rides package site, or at least half the site will be for a flat rides package, or it could be the site of the relocated Goliath from Six Flags New England. So I'm going to share my thoughts on it right now. So there we are, ladies and gentlemen, thrill seekers of all ages. That is what is the situation right now about Geronimo Skycoaster. It's been removed from the park's website. Looks like it's gone. Looks like it's all been removed from there. And it looks like the ride's going. So, take into account that and the nearby Nightmare Mine building, what could I see coming into this site? Well, I spoke to you about two specifics. I spoke to you about flat rides package and a brand new coaster, or technically a new coaster for the park. So first of all, the flat rides package. I think that a flat rides package could take up half the site, or maybe all of the site, you never know. You know, there's multiple different routes that could go down. They could go with one of the ABC tour balloons if they wanted to, or they could go down like a pair, like some family rides maybe. They could go down the family ride route, or they could go down, I mean, they could go with a Larson Super Loop if they want. Well, I think they've already got it, so they wouldn't go with a Larson. They couldn't go with two Larson Super Loops, could they? And they couldn't relocate the current one. So, I mean, there's a few different routes you could go down in terms of flat rides. I mean, you see these sort of swing rides being added in the recent years, like the Giant Discoveries. Maybe it's the rumored Screaming Swing that's been talked about in the last year from Six Flags. Obviously, we spoke about this in previous videos about the rumor from last year about there being an RMC Raptor, an SNS follow-up to Max Force, a Premier Coaster Project, a Screaming Swing, and some Zampella family rides. Maybe the Screaming Swing could be for Frontier City. On the other hand, they could go with a brand new coaster. When I say brand new, I don't technically mean brand new. Because one thing they could go, or one route they could go down, is to bring in Goliath from Six Flags New England. And that's been the rumor for quite some time now. The big rumor has been that Goliath from Six Flags New England would be relocated to Frontier City. And that was my main prediction from the start with this part for next year. But I always thought the Thunder Road Raceway, which is the go-karts attraction, that would be the site it would take up. However, it does throw into question now whether they go with that site or they go with this site where Geronimo Skycoaster was and also the Nightmare Mine coaster building was. So I think both sites are big enough for Goliath. Or they might not even go with Goliath. They might do that for the following season. And you know, this season might just be all about taking the ride down and getting it in storage ready for a following season. Or they might go with multiple things. They might put Goliath in one location and go with a different coaster in another location. So let's say, for example, if they're going to put in two coasters, which is very unlikely for Frontier City, but let's go off the basis of if it will be two coasters for next year. If you put Goliath in the Thunder Road Raceway building, the Thunder Road Raceway site, what could you do then with the Nightmare Mine building and the Geronimo Skycoaster site? What you could do is a Raptor coaster. Now, we're not talking about a custom one, we're talking about the prototype layout. And I don't think that would be a bad investment for Frontier City. Again, they could go with a nice, patriotic or western theme, something like the New Revolution or something like that. I mean, that's obviously, it's a very Six Flagsy thing to do, but you know, I wouldn't mind that name, to be fair. Revolution or the New Revolution, obviously, or Lone Star Revolution. That's a very Six Flags thing to do. I'm trying to think like Six Flags. I think it should be very interesting to see what happens. Obviously, we don't know if this site will be a new 2022 site. We don't know that for sure or not. We don't know if there will be multiple things going on for next year at Frontier City. I think it should be an interesting watch, though. Stay tuned in July for my final predictions videos, because I might might have my mind made up by then. But there we go, guys. Thank you very, very much for watching this video. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe. Stay tuned for the Six Flags Fiesta Texas update in a few hours' time, hopefully. Fingers crossed. And for now, guys, my name is Curtis Shell. Keep learning the coast of life, and I'll see you guys in the next video very, very soon. Take care, guys. Have a frontier-tastic day. Yeehaw!